Welcome to Naples in southern Italy for the fourth day of shooting action at the 2019 Summer Universiade. This is the 60th anniversary of this multi-sport event. It brings together the world's best university athletes every 2 years. And in 2019, nearly 6,000 athletes from 112 countries in action. This is the last day of individual action in shooting, taking place at the Mostra d'Oltremare venue to the west of Naples. Today, a new women's 10-meter air pistol champion will be crowned. Fans looking forward to that. This is the fourth event over 10-meter range. It's a very, very high-quality field. We've got two Olympians here. We've got three junior world champions, so we should have good quality. So we've had five shots, and Dosa Arabshahi of Iran is first, ahead of the pre-tournament favourite Kim Min-jung, who is in second place. 1.9, it's a big gap, but there is plenty of time. Remember, a second series of five shots and then the elimination. Helen Oh is struggling at the moment, as is Xiao Lilia. They're the ones who have to make up the pace. And you can see it. Disappointing shot there. Arabshahi is at 8.8, a nice 10.3 for Kim, and a huge 10.8 for Deswal. Yashaswini Deswal of India. That's the best shot so far. The 22-year-old from Chandigarh, northwest India. I'm sure many of her friends and family following this program. An economics student, former junior world champion. That was a couple of years ago in Seoul, Germany. She equaled the junior world record there, so we should not at all be surprised if Deswal is a big threat. 10.3 for Arabshahi, consistent. That's much better from the American. So the best shot there was Deswal with that 10.8. Still Arabshahi at the top of the standings. Into Yui Wen on the right of your screen from Chinese Taipei. She went to the 2012 and 2016 Olympics. So in terms of experience at the very top level, she is the one to look out for. Currently in fifth place, but it shows what a good quality competition this is when a two-time Olympian is by far from the favourites and by far from the top of the standings. Seeing 10.3 from Deswal. A disappointing 9.7 for Rostamian, the other Iranian, but Iran are filling two of the top four spots. A little erratic, certainly from Yu, who's going high and low, left. Oh, as well as going left and right. Still eighth out of eight, so she want to get off that position before the elimination round starts. Arabshahi shooting very consistently in what's the biggest final of her career. 89.5 so far. Kim Min-jung, the pre-event favourite, hovering not far behind. So another look at those shooting glasses, which are customizable and often extremely expensive. They can be made up to 100 pieces. And as I say, they're really about getting a focus both for the gun and for the target. Arabshahi has passed the 100 mark. With a 10.8. She's not showing any nerves at all. And she's pushing Deswal and Kim, who are probably the favorites ahead of this competition, all the way. Iran lead from India and South Korea. After the first five, Arabshahi led Kim and Yu. American support for Helen Oh. And we have had the 10 shots, second series of five shots. And Arabshahi has maintained the lead, you know, and she's nearly a point ahead, 0.9 points ahead. will be absolutely delighted with that ahead of Deswal and Kim. No surprise who fill the top three. But Helen O and Xiao Lia have work to do, because we're soon going to come to the elimination phase. The gap is 0.9 points. Arabshahi, Deswal and Kim, the top three. USA and China in trouble. Oh, and Xiao Lia. At the other end, Arabshahi is the only scorer who's passed 100 points. After 10 shots, she leads. And Deswal and Kim, Rostamian, also in the top four for Iran. And a 10.6 for Yu. And a 10.5 for Rostamian. The Iranian shooting well, and a poor 7.6 for Tomala, and she knows it. You just saw her in her screen there. Knew she'd made a mistake. So after 11 shots, still Arabshahi, but it looks like it's the end of the challenge from the USA. Helen O, surely too far behind to make up 2.7 points. That's the gap between Xiao and O. Let's see what happens. Arabshahi's lead is 1.1 points, you know. Pre-competition talk was of Kim, Rostamian, certainly of Deswal. It's the other Iranian who's doing really well, Dorsa Arabshahi. So, loading for shot number 12. No, Helen O will have to do something absolutely exceptional here. Here she is. Left-handed. Needs to be perfect, I think, and just hope that her opponents do something catastrophic. Ho has hit a 10.2. That's a good score. I don't think it'll be enough.
Stop.
And Xiao has hit 9.9. It's Helen O, the first to be eliminated. Eighth place, the US national champion. But, you know, she's done really well to get to the final. This is a high-quality field. So, well done to Helen O. Eighth place for her. Seventh in qualifying.
Very respectable eighth place.
So, we're down to the last seven in this final of the women's 10-meter air pistol competition. And a bit of a surprise at the top with Dorsa Arabshahi. The favourites, Deswal and Kim, just behind 0.8 points and 1.2 points behind the leader. And the first shooter eliminated was from the USA. Hello. After 12 shots then, it was Arabshahi, Deswal and Kim, the top three. We're getting to the business end of this final, the fourth and final individual final. The pistol and rifle events in Naples. That's the end of shots 13 and 14. We've seen a really good shot there from Deswal, a 10.6. And on the other end, a disappointing 8.8 from Tomala, who's got huge work to do to overtake Yuai Wen now, as you can see. The shooters have a monitor, as you can see, just in front of them, so they can see the scores and also see how much time is left. Probably more importantly, Arabshahi's at a 9.9. That's a bit disappointing for the Iranian. What's Deswal got up her sleeve, I wonder? 9.2. Oh, dear. She'll be disappointed with this. That might be the chance for Kim to make up ground. Kim Min-jung, the favourite, completely dominated the qualifying with that score of 582 points. Waiting for Kim's 10.1. Oh. Nicely done, and a 10.8 for Rostamian. Well, I was looking at the top three, but fourth place, Rostamian has hit a 10.8. Brilliantly done from Hania Rostamian. And suddenly she's in contention. What a competition we're having. It's Iran 1 and 2. But eliminated Joanna Tomala of Poland. Seventh place for her. So after 14 shots, it's Iran 1 and 2. Adab Shahi is still ahead. But now it's Rostamian second and Deswal third. This is developing into a wonderful final in Naples. We've had 14 shots of the 10-meter air pistol competition, and suddenly there are two Iranians in the top two, but it is very, very tight. The favorites were Deswal and Kim, and they're certainly not out of it, as you can see. 10.9, the maximum per shot. And that Yu is shooting quite quickly, and maybe that was a strategic mistake, 9.1. Adab Shahi is a 10.4. 10, 10.3 for Deswal, that's better. And the Iranians on their feet with a 10.4 for Adab Shahi. She's going to extend her lead. She's been top all the way as Dorsa Adab Shahi. Quite incredible. It's very rare that you see that, especially from an outsider. She'll be disappointed if she doesn't hang on to this. She's been ahead since that break after five shots. We've had 15 shots now. And the next to be eliminated will be Xiao or Yu Ai Wen. It's China or Chinese Taipei now looking to stay in the competition. So who will be sixth, I wonder? Creditable performance, but always disappointing when you get to a final not to be in the hunt for a medal. Chinese shooter, 22 years old on Saturday, just turned 22. Be a lovely present, wouldn't it, to go home with a medal. Junior World Championship gold in the 25-meter air pistol in Seoul was Xiao. And she has hit a 10.1. A 10 dead for Deswal, and a disappointing 9.6 for Kim. And Rostamian is just going from strength to strength. 10.8. Confirmation that Yu Ai Wen is out of a Chinese Taipei. She is in sixth place.
Congratulations to her. That's actually her first medal in 10 years, so very well done to her. Well, for the second time in three shots, the Iranian Rostamian shot in.
So after 16 shots, it's still in Iran 1-2. Rostamian 1, Adab Shahi 2.
Next competition shot, low.
We're getting ready for the next shot in this 10-meter air pistol final. We've had 16 of them. And for the first time, it's Hana Rostamian who leads. She's overtaken her countrywoman, Dorsa Adab Shahi. No doubt that Rostamian, the more experienced of the two, got a bronze medalist at the 25-meter air pistol World Cup event in New Delhi this year. Never been a finalist at senior level. And there's a real scrap between the two Iranians. But don't rule out Yashashwini Deswal of India, who's shooting very well. 10 dead there. Disappointing for Kim as well. Well, the favorite, as does happen. Just hard to keep up that consistency. And Rostamian will be very disappointed as well with a 9.1. After 17, then it's going to be between the favorites, Kim Min-jung and Xiao Lia. Should be okay for Kim for the moment. But she'll want to get up the rankings and try and go home with a medal. So ready for the next shot now. Adab Shahi leads. Deswal has got between the two Iranians. 0.3 points ahead of Rostamian. But at the moment, we're looking at Kim and Xiao Lia, South Korea and China, who will be eliminated. Most likely the Chinese shooter. She's had a 10.1. Rostamian's had a big 10.7. back in contention, and 10.6 for Kim. And confirmation, it will be Xiao finishing in fifth place. Zhao Liya was third in qualifying and will finish fifth. And that's a very creditable performance in a high quality field. So we have had 18 shots. And Dorsa Arab Shahi is back in the lead ahead of Ross Demir. And again, it's in Iran 1-2 with India and Deswal third. We're getting ready for shot 19. We're down to the last four. This is where it gets very, very nervy. And Dorsa Arab Shahi is a surprise leader at the moment from Iran. 0.2 ahead of her countrywoman, Aras Damian, and the Indian shooter, Yashashwini Deswal. And Kim Min-jung has a lot of work to do here to get a medal. The woman who dominated qualifying with that 582 points. Couldn't quite keep it up. A huge 10.7 for Arab Shahi. It's a 10.9 for Kim. You can hear the Koreans on their feet. You cannot ask for more than that. A perfect 10.9. Well, they often say the best athletes come good when it really matters. And Kim Min-jung shot absolutely superbly there. And that means she's level with the Indian Yashashwini Deswal. Brilliant shooting from Kim Min-jung. We knew we had it in her because she was so good this morning. Well, this is getting closer and closer. If you want to be in one position, it's top, and Dorsa Arab Shahi will be delighted, but it's very, very close. Let's see whether Deswal or Kim will at least be assured of a medal. So tough to finish fourth, isn't it? It's going to be the fate of one of these shooters. Arab Shahi's okay. Here we go. All this hard work, all the concentration and hours of practice comes to. It's a 10.8 for Rostam Mian. And the Iranians this time are cheering on their shooter. Hania Rostamian, superbly done. And suddenly she's in with a real chance of a gold medal, but eliminated, and that's a bit of a surprise. Yashashwini Deswal went all the way. And she was second and third all the way through, but couldn't quite stay in that top three. A real disappointment for Deswal. Came sixth in the recent Youth Olympic Games, but there's not going to be a medal here either. Deswal out, finishing in fourth after coming second in the qualifying. We have the last three in the 10-meter air pistol final. We know the medalists. There'll be two from Iran, one from South Korea. Dorsa Arab Shahi, Hania Rostamian, and the favourite, Kim Min-jung, but Kim has a lot of work to do. Arab Shahi, a reasonable 9.7. I'll be a bit disappointed with that. Kim needs a huge number here. She's got a 10 dead and a 10.1 for Rostamian. And the Iranian delegation is enjoying this. You know, Iran has sent a couple of journalists here. I saw them earlier interviewing their shooters. And they've come here with hopes. They've already won one medal, and they're going to get two more here. And in all likelihood, it's going to be a shootout between two Iranians for the gold. And the next shot will decide that medal. It's Rostam Mian, Kim, who are in second and third. The gap between one and two is only 0.1 points. Well, this is really dramatic stuff in Naples. I hope you're enjoying this, and certainly Iranian fans are enjoying it. Iran will get two medals. Which color will they be, I wonder? 10.6 for Arab Shahi. She'll be delighted with that, and only 10 for Kim. And Kim will have to be content with the bronze. The woman who was superb in qualifying. Certainly no shame in third. You can see that perhaps she was looking for more. But congratulations, Kim Min-jung of South Korea goes home with the bronze. South Korea for bronze, Min-jung Kim. We're down to the last two shots in the women's 10-meter air pistol competition, and it's Iran against Iran with half a point difference between Dorsa Arabshahi and Hania Rostamian, who, in terms of experience, the top level would be the favorite, but she has to make up half a point, which is not negligible in these circumstances. Half a point between Arabshahi and Rostamian, Iran against Iran. Who will go home with the gold? It's a poor 9.6 for Arabshahi. And a very poor 9 for Rostamian. Well, Rostamian, the door was open. The opportunity was there for a gold, and you can see that Hania disappointed with that. Arabshahi shot first. Rostamian just taking a few more seconds, but it didn't make the difference. It's looking very, very good for Dorsa Arabshahi. This will be the biggest day of her shooting career, no doubt about that. Arguably already is, but if you go home with a gold, this is an absolutely huge day for her and a very good day for Iran. The gap is 1.1 points. That's a big gap to make up for Rostamian. Dorsa Arabshahi just has to hit something solid here. And Arabshahi will have the gold. Will nerves play a part, I wonder? It's 9.5, 9.8, Arabshahi. 9.8 for her. And there is your answer. She did come up with the goods when it mattered. Dorsa Arabshahi, what a surprise and what a brilliant performance from her. Well, it's a winning smile, and doesn't she deserve it? Because she led for almost all of this competition. She was ahead after rounds 12, 14, 18, 20. It's nice to see two shooters who know each other so well, obviously. They've spent the last few weeks together preparing for this event, and it couldn't have been any better for Iran. There you have it. That's the top three. Iran, Iran, South Korea, Arabshahi with the gold medal. Absolutely delighted with that. Well done to her. Hana Rostamian second, and Kim Min-jung with the bronze. But there's the gold medalist from Iran, Dorsa Arabshahi.